Hello everyone. So today in this session, we are going to discuss the concept of Taylor method. So we can call this Taylor method as the main name of the Taylor method is the Quine-McLeish method. Okay. So this Quine is one of the mathematician and McLeish is the mathematician. These two people, they combinedly formed or they combinedly introduced a method called as Taylor method, and this method is useful for us for the minimization of Boolean functions into a minimum number of terms. Okay, so this is the method Quine-McLeish method, which is preferred after the K-map. Okay, in order to overcome the limitations of K-map, so we are using this method, which is mainly useful for simplification of Boolean expression into a minimum number of terms. Okay. So before discussing about this particular topic, first let us know what is the limitations of K-map. Okay, as we are having K-map as a main method for simplification of Boolean expression, why we are going to new technique? Why we are going to this technique? So there should be some drawbacks or there should be some disadvantages or limitations for the previous method as K-map, and let us know what are the limitations, then you can see about this Quine-McLeish method, which is called as Taylor method. Okay, so let us see the what are the limitations of K-map. Okay, so this K-map have some limitations, right? What are those? This K-map method of simplification is convenient only when the input variables, the number of input variables, is less than 5 or 6. Okay, so what we are saying here, see, generally we will write expression like f of a comma b. It means that the function f is depending on the two input variables a comma b. So till now, how we are finding input variables? We are just verifying how many variables are written in the brackets. So 2 here. Suppose 3 means we will find like f of a b c. Okay, 3 input variables dependent means the function will be like f of a comma b comma c. Okay, so like that the function will exist. So here you can clearly say that 3 input variables are there. Like that, this K-map can be it will be suitable for us only up to maximum either 5 variables or 6 variables, up to 5 or 6. Okay, so for a period of time, you remember like 6 variables maximum, you can solve an expression with 6 input variables by using K-map. Suppose if it exceeds more than 6, that means like 7 input variables, 8 input variables, 9 input variables, and so on. In that conditions, this K-map will become more complex for us. Why the complexity comes here? See, for 2 number of input variables, we need 4 cells for simplification. Next, for 3 input variables, we need 8 cells for simplification. This time writing 2 power n concept. For 4 input variables, we need 16 cells for simplification. So we know how to simplify these 3. Okay, we have seen many examples previously. Suppose 5 input variables are there, then you need to use 32 cells. That means your K-map will be very large. Suppose if you take 6 cells, you need to have 2 power 6. 2 power 6 is 64 cells. You need 64 cells for simplification. That means whenever the number of input variables are increasing, go on increasing, obviously the number of cells required will also goes on increasing. Okay, clear? So due to that purpose, up to this six input combinations, your K-map will helpful for you for simplification easily. Okay, maximum up to 6 input variables you can do with K-map. Suppose if your input variables goes on increasing more than 6, then this method will become very, very complex for simplification. Okay, see, if the number of input variables are increases, then it is difficult for us to make the finless expression. Clear? So if number of input variables are more than 6, remember this point, if it is greater than 6, then definitely this K-map will become difficult for us in order to get the output expression. Okay, so this is the one of the drawback in KMap. This is the first drawback in KMap. Next. Already this KMap, what is the KMap? It is a manual method. It is a manual method. It means first of all, you need to draw a KMap. Okay, you need to frame the KMap. So we have many steps here. So it is a manual technique. In this technique, suppose if you have more number of input literals dependence, so when the number of input variables goes on increases, obviously as it is a manual technique, the simplification process will become complex. Okay, so due to this complexity, we are moving to the, so to overcome these limitations, we prefer the new technique called as Quine and McLeusin method, which is called as tabular method. Okay, clear. So what is the main drawback here? This KMap is only limited, or it is only suitable for simplifying the expression which consists of less than 6 input variables. If the number of input variables exceeds 6, then this KMap will become complex for us in the simplification. Then, so for that purpose, to overcome that limitation, we are preferring a new method called as Quine-McLeusin method, which is called as tabular method. Clear? So very, very important for the 2 marks question. What is the limitation of KMap? KMap is limited up to the simplification of an switching function, which is depending with less than 6 variables. If the number of input variables exceeds 6, then definitely this KMap will become very complex for us. That is the main limitation. So to overcome that limitation, we are going with a new method called as Quine and McLeusin method. Okay, clear? And now we will see the what are the steps we need to follow for simplifying the Quine-McLeusin method, which is called as tabular method. Okay, the simplification rules. So what is the first step? First, you need to list all the min terms in the binary form. Okay, they will give the question, right? So in that question, observe what are all the min terms you are having. So you arrange all the min terms in an order and write them in binary form. Next, what is second step? You arrange all the min terms. All the min terms means whatever min terms existing in the first step, all the min terms should be arranged according to the order of ones. Okay, order of ones. It means that suppose if you are having a single number of one, take all the single number of ones min terms into one group. If you are having two number of terms in binary form, take two number of ones into one group. Okay, like that. According to the number of ones present in the binary format, you make these min terms in a group. Okay, that is the second step. Next, third step is, after making the groups, you need to compare each and every binary number with each and every term in the adjacent group. Okay, suppose in the step number two, if we have three groups, group one, group two, group three, then what is the third step? You should compare all the min term present in the first group with all the min term present in the second group. Okay, you should compare all the min terms present in the first group with all the min terms present in the second group. Likewise, you should compare all the min terms in second group with all the min terms in third group. Like that, each and every adjacent groups should be compared with each other. Okay, compared with each other. And while comparing, if you find any 1-bit position difference, okay, it should be differ in only 1 bit. Very, very important. 1-bit position difference. Then only you should take that combination to the next step. Okay. While comparing, definitely you will find the difference between the bit positions. And you focus only on the terms which are differing with only 1-bit position. Only 1-bit position. Those combinations only should be taken to the next step. Okay. Clear? And then you need to apply the same process. That step number three is repeated continuously until the comparison is not possible. Okay, step number three is applied. Thus apply the same process and it is continued until the comparison is not possible. Okay, until the comparison is not possible. Next. And then you list all the time implicants from the table. Okay, there will be a last table, which is comparison not most possible. From that, you list all the prime implicants. Okay. And then Finally, you frame an prime implicant table or prime implicant chart. See the prime implicant chart, and by using this chart, you will find the final expression. Okay. These are the main basic steps or the main important steps to follow in order to simplify any problem regarding Quine-McLoughlin method. Very, very important steps. Okay, clear? Next. So now we will see the example. So please carefully observe and follow the steps. Okay. See here. This is the example given. Simplify the Boolean expression using Quine-McLoughlin method, which is called as Taylor method. Here they have given four input variables and they have given some cell numbers. Okay, this is the given question. Summation m in the sense it is an SOP question. Okay, this is not KMAP, so you should not draw 16 cells here. This is a different method called as Taylor method. So what is the step? What is first step? First step is list all the min terms in the binary form. Okay, I am writing again the steps here so that it is easy for you to follow. Okay, so what is first step? List all the min terms in the binary form. All the min terms in the sense, see what is min terms given here? M0, M2, 3. Okay, let me draw here. It is easy to analyze. M0, M2, M3, M6, M7. All these are your min terms. Small m means min term. Likewise, M10, next M12, and M13. So directly you should write how many terms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In total, we are having 9 min terms. 9 min terms. 9 min terms. What are those? M0, M2. So like that, you write all these in an order. Okay. Okay. So write them. So here, first you draw a table like this. For each and every step, you will have a table. Okay, that's why it is called as a Taylor method. For each and every step, there is a table. And these will be the two common columns present in each and every table. For every table, you will have two columns. One column is min term column. Second column is binary representation column. Okay, first column is min terms column. Second one is binary representation column. Okay. So first note all the min terms. See M0, M2, M3, M6, M7, M8, M10, M12, M13. All I noted. All the 9 min terms I have noted in order. Okay. Write all them in order. Now convert these base values. What is the index value here? 0. So convert 0 into binary form. 4 zeros. What is the value of 2? 2 in terms of binary. 0010. By using 8421, you can convert these index values into binary numbers. So 3 in terms of binary means 0011. 6 in terms of binary means 0110. 7 in terms of binary means 0111. 8 in terms of binary is 1000. 10 in terms of binary is 1010. 12 in terms of binary is 1100. 13 in terms of binary is 1101. Like that, you convert all the index values. Index values means this one, 0, 2, 3, 6, 7, all these are your index values. Convert these values into binary form by using 8421 system. That is the first step. Okay. List all the min terms in the binary form. So these are all the min terms and these are all the binary forms. Okay. First step is completed. Now go for step number 2. Observe carefully. Okay. See. What is second step? You need to arrange the minterms. You need to arrange the minterms according to the number of ones present in the binary form. Okay. You need to arrange the minterms according to the number of ones present in the binary form. So if you observe the previous step, see, this M0 doesn't consist of any one. Okay. This binary format doesn't contain any one present in it. So 0 number of ones are present here. Okay. How many number of ones present here? 0. So take this M0 as separately. So I mentioned a color, different color, which indicates it is a different group. M0 consists of 0 number of ones. 0 number of ones. No ones is there. Next. single number of ones, where are they? Verify. M2 consists of single number of 1, M8 consists of single number of 1. Okay, zero number of ones is completed. Now single number of ones, single number of ones is M2 and M8. So write those two in one group, make them as one group, M2, M8. I mentioned it as one group. Okay, I mentioned it separate color. Okay, M0 is separate group, M2, M8 is separate group. Okay, clear. Now single number of ones completed. Next, go for verification of two number of ones in the previous step. Two number of ones, where are they? M3, two number of ones are there. M6, two number of ones are there. Next, M10, two number of ones are there. M12. So M3, M6, M10, M12. See, M3, M6, M10, M12. Write their respective binary forms here. Each binary form should have 2 2 1s only. Clear? Next, 2 1s completed. Next, find the verification of 3 1s. 3 1s means M7 is there and M13 is there. Only 2 terms. So M7 and M13. Okay. What is the second step we have done here? The second step we have done is, depending on the number of ones present in the binary form, we made them into groups. Here, 0 number of ones are there. Here 1 1 is there, here 2 1s are there, here 3 1s are there. So by using this number of ones present in the binary form, I made into groups. So this is the first group, this is second group, this is third group. See the colors. Okay, next, this is fourth group. So this is the second step. Okay, total 4 groups are made depending on the number of ones present in the binary format. Okay, next, what is the next third step? What is third step? Compare each binary number with every term present in the adjacent group, and if they differ it in 1-bit position, if they differ in 1-bit position, note that combination. You observe this step very, very carefully. This is the third step, and this is the table of third step. Okay, why I drawn this means frequently I should change the slide. Okay, frequently I should change the slide so that I copied the same table. I copied the same table here for rough work. Okay, this is not drawn again. No need to draw this again. Just for the verification purpose, I copied the same table again here. This is the original table of step number 3. This is the original table of step number 3. Okay, kindly observe that. See, what is the process here? This is first group, this is second group. Okay, let me write. This is group number 1, this is group number 2. What I am saying is, each and every term present in the first group should be compared with each and every term present in second group. That means M0 should be compared with M2. Again, M0 should be compared with M8. Okay. All the terms present in the first group. All the terms means we are having only one term. So that one term is to be compared with all the terms present in the second group. All the terms present in the second group means M0 should be compared with M2. Next, same M0 should be compared with M8. Then the comparison will be completed between 1 and 2. Okay. And while comparison, if 1-bit position is there, then only you should write your answer in the next step. See, when you compare 0, 2, when you compare 0, 2, you compare the binary formats of M0 and M2. See here first bit is 0, here first bit is 0, same. Here second bit is 0, here second bit is 0, same. Here third bit is 0, here third bit is 1. So this particular bit is changing. Okay, this particular bit is changing. Okay, next, fourth bit is 0, here fourth bit is 0. So among 4 bits, we find only 1 bit is different. Okay, carefully listen my statement. When I am comparing M0 with M2, I found out that among the 4 bits, only 1 bit is going to be changed. That's why, as it is an 1-bit variance, I will write this combination the next step here. So the combination is 0, 2. And what is the answer you will have? See, first bit is same 0. So write 0 directly. second bit is 0, same, so write 0 directly. And we are having difference at third bit position. Okay, in the third bit position we are having difference, so that part is making with dash. Okay, the bit where it is showing difference should be replaced with dash. Next, the fourth bit is 0, so 0. So what is the answer we'll get here? 00-0. This dash is indicating your 1-bit difference. Okay, 1-bit difference. Clear? Okay. So 0, 2 answer is 00-0. Okay, only this particular third bit is changing. That's why in the place of third bit I kept a dash. And the remaining three bits are same, so I copy the same bits in my answer. Okay, clear? Now again, what is the task? 0, 2 is completed. Now go with 0, 8. 0, 8 means this representation compared with this representation. See here, the last three bits are same, 0, 0, 0. Here last three bits are same, 0, 0, 0. Only the first bit is different here. Only the first bit is different. So in the differing bit, you should replace dash. In the differing bit, you should replace dash. And the remaining bits are same. Here 000, here 000. So copy the same 000 here. Then this will be your answer. -000 is the answer for 0, 8. Okay. Clear? Next. Like that. So now 1, 2 comparison is completed. Okay, what I have done? I completed 1 and 2 comparison. Now 2, 3 comparison. Now 2, 3 comparison. How will you do? Compare M2 with M3, M2 with M6, M2 with M10, M2 with M12. After that, M8 with M3, M8 with M6. M8 with M10 and M8 with M12. Okay, so first compare M2 with all the terms present in the third group. Okay, first compare M2 with all this, and then compare M8 with all this. Then the comparison will be completed. Now what is the task? M2 with M3. You should write down the combination only for single bit variance. See here, compare this one with this one. You find here 001, you find here 001. Only this bit is changing, last bit is changing. So what you write the answer? You write the answer as the last bit is changing. That's why I kept dash in the last bit. The remaining three bits are same. So 2, 3 is added in my group. Okay. While comparison of 1 and 2, we got these two. These two will become as first group now. Okay. Now while you are doing with this, you are doing with these two. Right now you are doing with comparison of these two groups. So those should be written separately. Okay. That's why I changed the color, yellow color. So 2, 3 will be a new pair. And the answer is this one. Likewise, compare 2 with 6. 2 with 6, you will get this one as an answer. And 2 with 10, you will get only 1 bit position variance. Okay. Next, 2 with 12, very very important combination. Okay. 2 with 12, you find M2 and you find M12. What is the value of M2? 0, 0, 1, 0. What is for M12? 1, 1, 0, 0. If you find here, the first bit is differing, second bit is differing, third bit is different. Total we are having 3-bit differences. As per the rule, only 1-bit difference only you should write. But in the comparison, I got 3-bit differences. So I should not write the answer of 2, 12 in my group here. So I didn't write here 2, 12. Okay. Why? Because 2, 12 comparison leads to 3-bit variance. as per the rule, only 1-bit variance only should be included in the answer. As I am having 3-bit variance, I cannot take this 2,12 into my answer. Okay, so you eliminate that 2,12 group. Okay, leave it. So comparison of 2 is completed. Now comparison of 8 with 3, you won't get. 8 with 6, you won't get single bit. Okay, why? Because 8 bit 3 means, see here, this bit is varying, this bit is varying, this bit is varying. Total 3 bits are varying. So you should not type for 8,3. Now verify 8,10, sorry, 8,6. 8,6 means these two numbers should be completed. See, 100. So you are having these two. Both are different. Total, you find 3-bit variance here. So you should not write. Next. See, 8,10. 8,10, you find only 1-bit variance. That's why I written here. 8,12 also 1-bit variance. I written here. Okay. So now I hope we got a clear idea for what are to be written in the next step and what are not to be written in the next step. Okay. You should write only 1-bit positions in your next step. If 2-bit positions, 3-bit positions are different, you should not write them in your answer. Okay. Like that, when you compare these two groups, you got these two as the final answer. When you compare these two groups, you got these combinations as your answer. When you compare these two groups, you got these three as your answer. Okay. So totally, this is step number 2 table. This is step number 2 table. In step number 2 table, totally we have 4 groups. Okay, 4 groups are there. See here, 4 colors are there. This is first group, second group, third group, fourth group. Now we have reduced that 4 groups into 3 groups. Step number 3, we have reduced the 4 into 3. See, this is one group, second group, third group. Only 3 groups are there. 4 is been reduced to 3. Again, you apply same process for third step. It may reduce to 2. Like that, you should go on reduce the number of groups. Okay. So this is the table. This is the final table of step number 3. Okay. That's why I erased this. Only this will be your final answer. Okay. And now, when you're writing these particular combinations like 0,2, 0,8, 2,3, you go to the previous step, okay, and you put the tick marks which are all involving here. Okay, 0 and 2 means M0 is involving, M2 is involving. Next, 0,8 means M0 already put a tick mark, M8 tick mark. 2,3 means M2 already given tick mark, M3 tick mark. Okay, you collect the numbers here and put the tick marks in the previous step. So M6 is involving, here 6 is there. So M10 is also involving, see here M10 is involving. Next, M12 is involving, yeah, 12 is involving here. Next, 7 is involving, yeah, here 7 is involving, see, 7 is there. 13 is involving, yeah, 13 is involving. So in step number 2, all the minterms are involving in step number 3. That's why in step number two, you put all the tick marks here. Okay, in the right side, you put tick marks. M0 is involving, M2 is involving. So like that, all are involving. Okay. For M13 also, write tick mark. Put a tick mark here. Okay, like that, all the minterms are involving, so I kept a tick mark here. Okay, next. So step number 3 is completed now. Now again, copy the same table in step number 4. That's why I copied here for verification purpose. Only this table is the answer for step number 4. Okay, same process. Compare all these present in first term into all the groups in second term. Okay. See here, 0,2 is compared with 2,3. 0,2 is compared with 2,6. 0,2 is compared with 2,10. Like that. Okay. 0,2 with 2,3. 0, 2 with 2, 6, 0, 2 with 2, 10, like that you compare all the terms. So if you compare 0, 2 with 8, 10, then only you will get a single bit variance. Okay, likewise when you compare 0, 8 with 2, 10, here also you will get single bit variance. Okay, when you complete these two comparisons, you find only these two as your results. Okay, see 0, 2 with 8, 10. See carefully, what is the answer of 0, 2? 0, 0, -0. And what is the answer of 8, 10? 1, 0, -0. See, only this bit is changing. Only this bit is changing. The rest of all three are same. Here 0, here 0, here dash, here dash. When you are having same dashes, it means they are same. Here 0, here 0. So we find the last three are same. The first bit is only differed. So what is the answer? First bit is differing. So dash, second bit is 0, third bit is already dash, and fourth bit is 0. So dash 0, dash 0 is the answer for this one. Like that I written here. Likewise, when you compare second and third groups, when you compare second and third groups, you will get the answer these two. These two will be satisfied with single bit variance. Okay, so what is answer of 2, 3? 2, 3, 0, 0, 1, -. What is answer of 6, 7? 0, 1, 1-. See here, only this bit is changing. The rest of all bits are same. Here both are 0, here both are 1s, here both are dash. Okay, so how can I write the answer? First bit is same 0, second bit is differing, so dash, third bit is 1, fourth bit is already dash. So 0, 1- is the answer for this one. See here, 0, 1-, you got same for them. Okay, so then you can skip this. Okay, this is the only table for you. This is the only table for you. And when you observe here, these two combinations or these two values, we are getting same. See, -0, -0, -0, -0. So when the two combinations are giving same output, you can take any one into the answer. You can take any one. So you can eliminate any one of these two. Likewise, when you observe these two, you are getting same output values for these two columns. So you can take any one from these two. Therefore, you can simplify the table like, you can simplify the table like, okay, I took with 0 to 810, I eliminated this one. And I took 2, 3, 6, 7, I eliminated this one. I took only one from the two. Why? Because both these two are same and these two are same. Okay, so this is the fourth step. Again, you need to verify, what is this? This is the first group, this is second group. This is first group, this is second group. Again, you need to compare all the terms in first group with all the terms in second group. When you compare this, say here first bit is dash, here first bit is 0, both are different. Here second bit is 0, here it is dash, here is different. Here third bit is dash, different, here different. We find 4 bits are different with comparison. If it is single bit, then you can write it as next step, but you don't find single bit comparison, so you can stop the process here, okay? And put into merge here. Why? Because these both are not satisfying the comparison, right? Now, see here, by using these space, you need to tick mark in the previous step. What is previous step? See, what is previous step? 0, see, 0, 2 involving, yeah, involving. See, 0, 2 is involving here. 0, 8, yeah, 0, 8 is involving. Yeah, okay. 2, 3, yeah, 2, 3 is involving. Put tick mark. 2, 6, yeah, 2, 3, 6 is important. 2, 10, yeah, 2,10 is involving, put tick mark. 8, 10, yeah, 8,10 is involving, put tick mark. 8, 12, very, very important. 8,12 is not involving. Among these four combinations, you don't find any value like 8, 12. So put into mark here, very, very carefully. Put into mark for 8,12. Next. 3, 7, yeah, you find 3, 7, put tick mark. 6, 7, yeah, you find 6, 7, put tick mark. 12, 13, no, 12, 13 is not involving in the next step. So put an into mark, put an into mark for 12 and 13 also. Okay. So if you see this, okay, 8, 12, 12, 13. These two only not involving. Okay. So in the step number three. Only 8, 12 I kept into mark here. Carefully observe. Only 8, 12 I kept into mark, and 12, 13 I kept into mark. Other than these two, all are given tick marks. Okay. Here, only 8, 12 I kept an into mark, and only 12, 13 I kept into mark. Why? Because these two are not involved in the next step. Okay. Clear. Next. So. Here we have 2 into marks. Here we have 2 into marks. Okay, whatever the min terms which are given into mark, all those into marks are your prime implicants. Very very important. Those who are not involving and remain alone like into mark, those into marks should be taken as your prime implicants. In the previous step, what are the into marks given? 8, 12, 12, 13. Remember that 8, 12, 12, 13. And right now we are having these two. Okay, so in the next step, what you like, list all the prime implicants. What are those? 8, 12, this is the first into mark, 12, 13, this is the second into mark, and in the previous concept we have these two, 0, 2, 8, 10 is 1, 2, 3, 6, 1 is 10. So these I copied as it is here. Okay, and I copied the same, the binary representation, what they have. 8, 12 they have 1-0, 0. 12, 13 we have 110-. So 0, 2, 8, 10. What we are having? -0-0. So I written here. And 2, 3, 6, 7. What we are having? 0-1-. So I written here. Okay. Just you copy the min terms which are given into mark. So from the entire problem, we find only 4 into marks. So I written those 4 here, and I written their own their respective binary formats. Okay, right. Next step, how to write the final answer. Okay, see here, this is nothing but your input A, this is input B, this is input C, and this is input D, and you are dealing with SOP. So remember the point. Okay, so one in terms of A is A. Here dash is there for B. Dash is there in the sense B is missing in the term. Okay, B is literal, which is missing in the term. So B will not exist. Okay, dash indicates that that particular literal is absent. Now C in terms of 0 is C bar. D in terms of 0 is D bar. So the answer of 8, 12 pair is A C bar D bar. A C bar D bar. Write like this here. Likewise, if you find here A in terms of 1 is A, B in terms of 1 is B, C in terms of 0 is C bar. Here dash is there for D, so D is absent here. So A B C bar is the answer. Next, if you find here A is absent, C is absent. Only we find B comma D. So 0 in terms of B is B bar. 0 in terms of B is D bar. So B bar, D bar is the answer. When you observe here, A is here A bar, C is here C. So A bar C is the answer. Like that, you should find the prime implicants by using the binary format. Okay. Now, what is last step? We need to draw the prime implicant chart. Very, very important to draw the prime implicant chart. So this is the format of prime implicant chart. Note down all the combinations here, and we have found these values previously. Write those values, and what are all the min terms given the question? M0, M2, M3, M6, M7. Write all in the columns. Okay, you should frame like this. This table is called as a prime implicant chart. Very very important. This table is called a prime implicant chart. Okay, the chart which involves all the prime implicants which resembles the output expression, which is called as a prime implicant chart. Okay, now. List out prime implicants on your left side, all the min terms on your right side like this. Okay, framing of this table is very, very important. Please practice this table. Now, first prime implicant is involvement of 8, 12. So, in the M8, you put a star mark. And M12, you put a star mark. Okay, it indicates that this term is involvement of M8 and M12. This is the meaning. Likewise, for this 12 and 13, right? So, M12 and M13. Next, for this 0 to 18. So, 0, 2, 8, 10. Next, 2, 3, 6, 7. 2, 3, 6, 7. Like that, you put star marks. Now, you, after filling of star marks, first of all, you find out the columns with a single star. Okay? Find out the columns present with a single star. You see here, M0 is a column with finding a single star here. We find only one star in the column. So directly take that value into the answer. Okay. You write a final answer f is f of ABCD equal to. You find M0 is having a single star. So directly what is single star here? The star is the involvement of this particular term B bar D bar. So take that into your answer. B bar D bar plus. Next we have M3 single column. M6 single star. M7 single star. M3, M6, M7 having the same stars in the same term, A bar C. Okay. Here is same term, here is same term, here is same term. Okay. M3, M6, M7. These three are having single stars. That two, all the single star lying on the same row. This A bar C. So directly take that value into the answer. A bar C. Next. Next M term is a single star. What is that bit here? B bar D bar. Already B bar D bar is written in the statement. So no need to write again. So completed. Next, go with M13. M13 is nothing but it is a single star, and that star is the answer for A B C bar. So write that here, A B C bar. So we have written three terms which are responsible for single stars. Then go for verification of double stars. M2 is the double star. See here. If double star is, it means that, see, if you find a double star like this, it means that you can take this in your answer, or you can take this term in your answer. You can take any one of these two. Suppose if you select this term as your answer, already this term is given. So no need to write. Suppose if you take this term as your answer, this term is also written here. So no need to write. So M2 is skipped here. M2 is skipped. Next, verification of 2 dot again, M8. M8, see here. Either you can take this term as an answer, or either you can take this term as your answer. Okay, two stars is there, means you have freedom of selecting either this term or this term. Okay. See, either you can take this term or you can take this term. Okay. And you verify whether any of the two terms is repeated in the expression or not. Any of the two terms is repeated in the expression or not. Already this term is repeated in the expression. So as per the rule, you can select either this one or this one. Suppose if you take this one, already this term is given in the statement. So no need to write again. So that this is completed. Likewise, if you take these two, you can take either this one or this one. Already this term is taken to the answer. What is that? A, B bar, C bar. So no need to write again. So all the columns are simplified. Okay. Like this, you need to write the final answer. Okay. First, you verify the columns of single dot. M dot is single. M3 is single. M6 is single dot. M7 is single dot. M10 is single dot. M13 is single dot. These are all the single dot columns or single star columns. Okay. Directly write your values. This star is responsible for B bar, D bar. So write in the answer. Next. This is the star. Same value. A bar C. Write here. This is also A bar C. This is also A bar C. So A plus A plus A plus A is equal to A only. When you write same term n number of times, you will get same answer. So for these three, For these three, we are having common answer A bar C. So write A bar C in the answer. Next. Next, M10. Already we written B bar D bar previously. So this is also completed. Next, last one is M13. This is the single star which is responsible for this term. So take the term into the answer. A, B, C bar. So single dot completed. Now go for verification of two star columns. M2 is 2 star, M8 is 2 star, M12 is 2 star. 2 star indicates that you need to verify this term, any of the two terms here existing in the term or in the given answer or not. B bar, D bar, already we included the term. A bar, C, this is also we included in the term. So as both terms are included previously itself, so you can skip this term. This is a simplified one. Next, to go with this one, either you can take this or you can take this. But as per the rule, if any one of these two is already written in your answer, then you can skip this column. Okay, as per the rule, if any one of these two terms is written in the answer, you can skip this. As per the rule, already B bar, D bar is are written in my answer. That's why I'm skipping this M8. Next, go for M12. You can take this. Or you can take this. As per the verification, if any one of these two is already involved in the answer, then you can skip this. See, this A, B bar, C, this term is already included here. So you can skip this. So already the remaining is complete. So still we don't find any values. Okay. Single dot, single star columns completed, double star columns completed. Triple star columns are not there, so that this is the final expression. Okay, this is the final expression. Okay, this is the final expression. If you simplify the same problem by using K-map also, you will get the same expression. Okay, if you want to verify, you take the same question, you go through the K-map and solve the K-map by using quads, pairs, depth method. And verify the expression what they you get there and what you get here. Both should be same. Okay, this is the method how to follow the Quine-McLusky method, which is called as Taber method. Very, very important method. So please practice the questions with more examples, but it will be very easy for you. Okay, so why we are going for this method means, in order to have or in order to overcome the limitations of K-map, we are using this. So what is the limitation of K-map? As the K-map is only limited for the input variables which are limited up to 6. Suppose if input variables exceed 6, then it is not flexible for us to continue with the K-map. That's why we are moving to the this particular method. And this particular method, what we are doing here, we are going to compare each and every group and we will find out the single difference, single bit difference, and that terms only you will take into the consideration. If 2 bits or 3 bits are, 2 or 3 bits are changing, you should not take them into consideration. And this is the very, very important one, prime implicant chart. And by using this chart, first you concentrate on single star columns, then you go for starting of 2 star columns. 2 star columns means either you can take this particular in your answer or you can take any one of the star as your answer. But before taking that, you verify whether any one of the star is involving previously or not. If it is involved, you can skip that column. If it is not involved, then you can have a freedom of taking any one of the term. Okay, any one, not a two. Clear? I hope everything is clear for you. Thank you for your cooperation. Have a nice day. We will meet in the next session with a new concept. Thank you.